I'm talking T25, trust, and what do you do with one of these? Hey, you've come to the right place where I share with you what it is that you need to know about the value of growing your own food. I'm Scott Poirier, and this is episode 4 of the Scott Poirier Yo, I gotta tell you, I'm excited to share some stuff with you today about the things that you need to know about growing, you know, food, good quality food. But let me, you know, before I get into all that, let me just talk a little bit about something that's just going on in my head right now, and I gotta see if I can get this out. I was actually reading online, you know, like when you hear a bad song, or not a bad song, but a song, well, I guess it is a bad song too, but a song that just gets in your head, and you're like, how do we get it out of my head, you know, and well, I have one of those songs, it's been rhythmic, just boom, it just keeps playing in my head, and I don't know how to get it out. So believe it or not, some people have actually created lists of things that you can do. So I'll give you a few that I picked up on. Like, you know, one of the things you could do is you could find the biggest hammer you can get, and you can put like your hand on the table, and you can just whack your hand with it. That's probably going to help you a lot, you know, to get rid of that song that's in your head. You know, another thing you could do is you could go up to the wall and just start banging your head on the wall in a different rhythm than you're hearing the song going on in your head. Another thing you could do is you could, I suppose, sing the song, you know, like, walk like an Egyptian. And that would probably change any other rhythm going on in your head. Or you could just take a pillow and stick your face in there and scream as loud as you can. Or you can do what I'm doing now. Talk about it enough that maybe you just get all the yuckies out with this song that's driving you crazy, and all of a sudden you've talked about it so much you're not remembering it anymore. So that's one thing. Now you might be thinking, well, what song is it? I hate to admit it because I really like this guy. I like this particular artist who's been singing like since the 60s, okay? I mean, Paul McCartney. How do you not like Paul McCartney? I love this guy. I love his music. But there's this Christmas song, a Paul McCartney Christmas song. I was in a small grocery store, kind of a mom-pop kind of grocery store today, and they had this music playing in the background, and this Paul McCartney song came on. You're probably familiar with it, right? Like one of the lyric in the chorus goes, you know, I'm having a wonderful Christmas time, simply having a wonderful Christmas time. I mean, you can sing that song without moving your lips. It's like, simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Now, it wasn't Paul McCartney singing the song. It was a different artist singing Paul McCartney's song. Simply have. I mean, I'm going to get it in your head now, right? Well, this guy that was singing the song, I swear he sang that chorus line like 30 times. I couldn't get out of the store fast enough, and all the way home trying to get here so that I could do this filming, it's just going on in my head. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time, and it's killing me. My left ear is bleeding, like it's just awful. So I needed to get all that out, and somehow I actually feel better going through some of this negative energy with you. Thank you for just letting me get it all out, and somehow I feel better. All right, so let me talk to you about some of the things that you need to know about growing food. So, and I'm going to tie this to something that I was doing this morning, and I do this routinely throughout my week. So this morning, early this morning, I was up, I was in my basement, I pop in my CD. This is, you know, Sean T. You know who Sean T is? Like Sean T, you know, the T25 workouts. We're talking 25 minutes of working out per day. I mean, that's all that Sean T says. It's as simple as that. Now, 25 minutes is still a commitment, right? I mean, you still got to, you know, take some time to put it off to the side to say, okay, I'm going to do this for 25 minutes. I'm going to do a workout for 25 minutes. And here's the thing. A lot of us are motivated at that level. I mean, a lot of us are motivated to say, I know I need to do something different so that I can live a healthier life. I feel like we're more aware about our health than we have ever been, maybe in the history of humanity. You know what I mean? We know a lot of stuff. We know that if we can stay physical, we can enjoy a lot of things. Like for me, one of the motivations for me to stay physical is I love to play racquetball, okay? So one of the things you need in racquetball is you got to have some pretty decent legs because you're doing some running around out there, okay? Using a lot of hip muscles and your thighs and a little bit of jumping and skipping around and stopping real quick and stuff like that. You got to have some pretty good legs. So one of the exercises here with T25 that I did this morning is a lower body workout. I mean, Sean T is saying, oh yeah, it's only 25 minutes of your day. But I'll tell you what, he gets every drop of the 25 minutes in that leg workout, and he'll bring you to the edge of the abyss, so it seems. And so for 25 minutes a day, I hate Sean T. But I got to tell you, for the rest of the day, for all the time that I'm awake, and I'm a pretty energetic guy, and I'm awake for a long time, like 17 hours a day, I'm thinking, I love Sean T. Because when I do these workouts, the benefit after throughout the day is I've got high energy. I've got a better self-image. You know, I see people differently. I actually see them in a better light. I have a better attitude. I make better decisions. I eat better quality food. By taking that 25 minutes of going, okay, it's going to take some effort for me to do this. But then for the rest of the day, I get to really enjoy a lot of, you know, the world around me, a lot of life around me. I'm telling you, gardening is very much the same way. It takes some effort to do some gardening. It takes some effort to get out there. Now, I don't want to scare you off. Like, for some of you who are kind of new and thinking, yeah, maybe I want to do this. Like, oh, I don't want to be, you know, brought to the edge of the abyss, you know, with gardening. I don't mean to equate it where it's that bad, but I'm saying that with some effort, with a little bit of effort, when you get out there into the soil, when you begin to learn how to grow food, it's going to take some consistency and some deliberacy and some effort to kind of walk through some things so that you can get to that point. At some point, you're like, I am enjoying, you know, the old saying, the fruit of my labor. That's part of the enjoyment, that when you give of yourself to something and it takes some effort, the result after is an awful lot of enjoyment. And in this case, we're talking about experiencing a lot of good, positive health. And that's what we know about more now than ever before. The value of eating good, quality food can go a long way. Well, I've been saying this for a long time. You can grow a lot of your own food. You're not going to be able to grow all of it unless you're in a very unique situation. But you could still grow a lot of your own food and have good control over the stuff you're growing and live a healthier, longer, more positive life than you have ever thought that you really could. And it's based on what it is that we eat. So keep in mind, a little bit of effort can go a long way in growing foods. I just want to prepare you for that. Now, this next thing I want to share with you, this kind of overlaps, okay? There's a lot of information out there in cyber world, right? There's a lot of people that talk about the kind of stuff that I'm talking about. And there are a lot of people that are pushing, you know, content and what I might call pseudo information, like, oh man, you can have an organic garden and harvest 800 pounds and eat off it year round. And you'll only have to dedicate 8 minutes a month and a half a gallon of water, and you can have all this. It's, you know, three easy steps and you can have this. And people fall for this kind of stuff. And what ends up happening has a very negative effect, because some people, because they really want to live healthier lives, and they think, okay, if it's that easy, maybe I'll go ahead and do it. And they buy the product, or they start doing what this person's telling them to do, and they realize without a long time into this, it's just not going to work. And so they figure, well, you know what? I'll just go buy my stuff at the store. And I mean, I'm not going to be able to grow my own stuff. Listen, I've been doing this for a very, very long time. There is a lot of value in growing your own food. There really is. Now, what we need is some discernment, and we need to be able to have people that we can trust. Now, there may be a lot of people talking about this, but, you know, we need to look for people that are like smoking what they're selling, okay? People that are eating the stuff that they're growing. People that have been doing this for a long, long time. Now, I would love to think that maybe I could tell you in a video, in a 10-minute video, here's everything you need to know about gardening, you know, live long and prosper, you know, kind of a thing. And it's like, but it doesn't work that way. Gardening is about opening yourself up, being willing to at least have some level of commitment to opening yourself up to learning some stuff. But in the process of doing that, I promise you, you'll live a better life, a more holistic life, a happier life, a healthier life. What we all have to do is look for people that we can really trust. It's like trying to find that one mechanic that we're like, yeah, that's the guy, you know, that I need to go to. We want to find those people that we can go to, that we can trust, that really know what it is that they're talking about. I'm hoping that as time goes on, that I can be one of those people for you. I'll walk with you through, you know, the experiences of your garden. I'll hold your hand. I'll jog alongside you and say, you can do it. You can do it, because I know you can. Anybody who wants to live a better life, a healthier life, if they have good people around them that they can trust, that they can really show them some of the things that they need to know about growing food, I'm telling you, it'll change your life. Okay, so the last thing. And then it all kind of ties in together, from, you know, T25, you know, a commitment to working hard, to then having, you know, people that you can trust to say, okay, I'm going to give it some commitment, and I'm going to follow this, and I just know at some point I'm going to benefit from it. And it's like, now we get to the theme of pomegranates, and it's like, what on earth do you do with this? You know, now I don't know if this is new for some people. That is a pomegranate. This thing's like a bunch of seeds, and they're wrapped up in like leather. And I've been eating these things since I was a kid. And I got to tell you, there's a lot of stuff we know about, you know, pomegranates. They're incredibly good for you, okay? And but it's like, how do you eat one of these things? And so I always just kind of cut the thing in half and just tore the thing open and, you know, had juice dripping off my elbows trying to get to those seeds. I love them. And it would take me, you know, 45 minutes to do it. But I love them enough that for years, I'm talking decades, I ripped these things open to get to the seeds to do it. Well, I saw this video of a completely different way, and I would say an easy way. I wouldn't say it's easy, you know, without any effort. I mean, it's going to take a little bit of effort, but I mean, relatively speaking, in the way that most people deal with a pomegranate, this is the easiest way to open up a pomegranate and to harvest the seeds that are on the inside, which will enhance your health. So with a little bit of technique and a little bit of information, you can butterfly one of these things. That's what I'm calling it, because it seems like that's what's going on. What happens is that someone evidently, you know, dissected one of these things, and they realized that there are 7 compartments in a pomegranate. Now, if you've ever seen the inside of a pomegranate, there are these membranes that separate each area. Well, evidently, every pomegranate has 7 compartments. I'm going to show you how to butterfly this thing, and it'd be the easiest way to get to the seeds in your pomegranate. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna come, let me bring this bowl right over here. So what you're gonna do is we're gonna cut along the top here. Now you have 2 ends, of course. You have what is, you know, this bigger piece, almost what would have been the flower end of the pomegranate. So what you wanna do is you're gonna sort of cut a crown. You don't wanna go too deep. You just wanna cut through the skin just a little bit. You'll be amazed how easily this thing comes off. And so you're going to just go like this all the way around. Okay? And here we are. Watch this. You just get your hand under there. Now you're going to already be able to see. Here, let me slide this over this way, because I want to put this down here. I'm going to just take the top off. Now, a few seeds will fall out, but I'm going to just take the top off. Now, if I can show you here close up, you're going to see there are these little white membranes. There are 7 of them here. Well, I guess there's 6 of them, giving it 7 compartments, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. So you have 7 compartments total. So you're going to locate each membrane, and I can see them here pretty clearly. One here, one here, one there, one there, one there, one there. All you do is you locate where that membrane is with your knife, and again, you're just getting below the edge of the skin. You're going to bring it all the way down to the bottom. Follow each membrane. It's amazing how easy this is. It's a little awkward doing this with the camera, so I got some of it dripping on me because of the angle that I'm holding it. But you will be amazed. This hasn't taken all that long to do, right? And looks like the other one's right here. It's going to almost be like the mouth of an alien when I open this thing up. You'll be like, what? Okay, so I think I got it. Yeah. All right, so you ready? So what? Oh, the other thing you got to do is you got to take this middle this middle piece out here with your knife. You don't have to go all that deep with it. It's just a kind of a surface piece. See that? Just take that out. And you ready? Watch this. And just take this and open it up. Look at this thing. Look at this. Can you believe? Can you believe? Here, let me get that right in the camera. Can you believe that? Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. So you rip off your piece, come over to your bowl. There's that membrane, that white membrane stuff. You can take that right out of there. And then you can take your seeds out. How's that for you? Yeah. It's the easiest way that I know how to get the seeds out of a pomegranate. Speaking about seeds, question of the day. I don't know if you've noticed watching this, if you recognize this shirt at all. Something tied to other things that I've done. But anyway, maybe I gave too big of a hint there, but let me just see. What I want to do is have you, again, look at this shirt. It's really my favorite shirt. I don't wear it a whole lot, but it's really a favorite shirt. And I want to know if you recognize the shirt. Listen, I've got, let me just show you this. In this little container right here, that is some scorpion pepper flakes, okay? I dehydrated these things. Scorpion peppers, I don't know if you know this, but a half a pound of dried scorpion peppers sell for like $80. It's unbelievable. So these things are like pungent. These babies are strong, okay? And I just love them. I eat them often. I put them in soup typically, and I eat soup pretty often because of all the tomatoes that I grow, okay? So I'm eating soup year round, dropping these flakes in there all the time. Absolutely marvelous stuff. This is like fire, blow your face off kind of fire. Right. So I saved 10 seeds for myself. I'm willing to split half of those seeds. I'll give to the person who recognizes my favorite shirt. I'll give them, I'll mail it to you. I'll give you 5 scorpion pepper seeds. And you can have fun growing scorpion peppers like I did. I gotta tell you, it's one of the easiest pepper plants to grow. Nothing touches it. The bugs don't want it. Nothing. Disease doesn't want it. I'm telling you, you put that seed in and it gets going. It's unbelievable. So there's your question of the day. Oh, subscribe. You gotta subscribe to me. Oh, subscriptions are like hugs. You know what I mean? Give me a hug. Give me a hug.